Yeah. Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Baby.
Good evening, late ballers and ballettes. Welcome to It's Been a Minute. I'm Coach Anand, and I'm here with my associate,
Coach Oli.
And we're here to just keep you up trending all the deets about the latest news of basketball and just, you know, trying to keep everyone updated. And this podcast is brought to you by Form Basketball. Coach Paul is in the building. Can I get a what's up from Coach Paul?
What up?
OG's here. And we're just going to start, get right into this. This is our first session, and don't hate us if we get some, make some bloopers and mistakes, you know. Don't worry, this stuff will be gold in the future. All right, Coach. Sure. I just wanted to ask you a couple questions about basketball in BC and club basketball scene. Did you ever train with anyone else other than Form Basketball?
Briefly, I coached split second.
Yeah.
Before starting Form.
Okay. Split second. That, I heard that's a good basketball program, actually. Yeah, I think my cousins went there. Did you have any good moments there, or what did you take or anything from that experience over there, Coach Paul?
Oh, yeah, it was great. You know, big shout out to Coach Eric Butler, who was one of the founders, one of the OGs of Split Second. They run a great program out there, catering to the young, youth, young athletes, getting them trained right. And then they eventually pass them off to us guys here who train the older guys. Solid program. Can't say enough good things about Coach Eric and Coach Kevin. Those guys are world-class guys. So big shout out to them, and inspired me to start Form Basketball as well too.
Amen to that. How about you, Coach Oli? Were you train anyone else anywhere else except Form Basketball?
Yeah, I started playing for Dynamite Basketball back in grade 9, I believe, and then played for a couple seasons in grade 9 and 10. And then grade 11 was where I started playing with Form Basketball. And throughout all these experiences with these club teams, I'm pretty much met a lot of people. And these people, they all pushed me to become a better ball player.
You definitely feel that these league teams in Vancouver, BC have really pushed you to be the person, not just the baller, just the person you are today.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's just saying something with the coaches in this area. They're doing something right. Right, Coach?
Right. So what about you? What about you, Anand? What about you?
Personally, I've only trained when I was, I'm not going to lie, I was not the greatest basketball player for honestly majority of my high school until I did the mainstream league clubs drive. That was like one of the bigger things when I was in grade 8, 9, 10 for like about, I think, 2 years. And then I just wasn't, maybe it wasn't myself taking basketball seriously. So I wasn't getting better. And then I didn't really play with anyone else. I trained by myself or with older teammates. And I had my coach Dykstra from Churchill. So Winston Churchill, shout out to him, played a couple of years in European League. He really worked my butt off. And then in this all-star game of my senior year, Coach Paul was my coach at the time, and he picked me up and recruited me. And that was the only place I ever played after drive with my final year at Form Academy. And I can't lie, it really changed my my perspective on team basketball, like working as a team. So I got to shout out Form Basketball for that one. That's about me. Okay, on to the next discussion. High school basketball scene. I know it's been a while since we're all graduates, and Coach, especially you graduated back in the prohibit areas, like prohibition days. But Oli, how long have you been out of high school?
I just graduated high school in the year of 2020, so during the pandemic.
Which high school did you graduate from?
I graduated from St. John's School, just about a block away from Kitsilano Secondary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that a private school or a public school?
Yeah, it's a private school. We're in the single A division for the basketball scene, and we play in the Javisa League. But, yeah.
Well, How do you think your team's doing right now? Do you have any update on them? Do you have any old connections?
Yeah, I still talk to some of the seniors right now that are on the team. Obviously, I think there's no basketball happening right now, school team-wise. I know there's club teams going on, but I think they're just running some practices on the Saturdays and Mondays and Wednesdays after school.
Keep them in shape.
Keeping them in shape.
Well, it's been about 2 years since I've graduated high school, and I played on my senior year. I was one of the only few seniors on my team, and the rest were grade 11s. But this is now 2 years ago we're talking about, and from what I remember, we had a couple of all-stars. We had Oli, we had Tiny. They both played drive, and I think they're doing really well for my Churchill team, my Churchill rep. Yeah. They don't have a season, so we can't really speak too much on them, my condolences go out. I'm lucky me and you, we graduated when we did, because these guys, they have some serious talent, and unfortunately they just can't put off for the school right now.
They don't get to finish out.
They don't get to show up. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah, exactly. Their fault, that's tough. They're
forced by this hand. So it really does suck. Some serious talent going on at Churchill right now, from what I remember and what I've heard small talk about. It's COVID. No one really talks to anybody right now, especially to the old schools, especially 2 years ago. But best wishes to those guys. Hey, Coach, I distinctly remember you are a Kitsilano coach. Any word from the senior team? Any prospects coming up? You want to shout out any one of your guys, your old guys, or someone from the current Kitsilano scene right now?
Well, I mean, I'm a former high school coach at Kits. Yep. You know, so being at the university level now as a coach, it's a treat, because you get to not only see some of the guys that you coached at the high school level, but you get to see all kinds of guys from across the country. I want to shout out, if you guys are listening, shout out to Tyrone, shout out to Luca Dolman, Peter Lee, out Dow, Lucas at Ryerson, Owen Cutler over at Concordia. And the big man in the middle, Everest Jags, he's out of Guelph.
That man gave me a beating in the paint.
Yeah, that man, he's a big man. He's a big man.
Big man. Has he gotten taller?
Yeah, he's gotten taller. I actually saw him yesterday. Randomly.
Oh, wow.
He's put on some size. So the big man in the middle, and
I remember
all those guys, they're killing it over in their various conferences. I got to say, for USports, USports is legit. You know, everyone wants to go down to the NCAA and play, but hey, USports is, you're representing Canada, you're staying in your own backyard or going to a different province and playing. And, to all you youngins, right, just don't look to the States, because you got to remember something. If you're you might be the best guy here, but there's a dude or 10 dudes down in the States who are just as good as you or better.
There's always
bigger than you, and they're American. So they're going to get more playing time, right?
Okay, Coach, I have that one just thing to just add on. Do you think Canadians have a chance against Americans? Do you think American basketball is at a different level? Or even Toronto basketball? I heard the Toronto scene's gone crazy right now. Do you think us British Columbians, us Vancouverites, can keep up with that level? Or is it just a lost dream, or can it actually be proven to reality?
Because everything just comes down to hard work.
Hard work. Because one of the most newest Canadian basketball players to the NBA scene is RJ Barrett, but he's not from. He's from, where is he from again? Ontario.
He's from Mississauga. He's from Mississauga.
Yeah.
So
Toronto boy.
Mississauga or Ontario area basketball scene is a lot different than Vancouver, and how and why?
It's tough.
It's a hard
question. There's obviously more people. There's more. Just a larger population. I just think that, again, like I said, it's boiled down to hard work. Like, one thing is BC's always got the size, and all you guys drink out your water here. I'm an Ontario boy, so out here I come and I see these guys, 6'7", 6'8".
You got some big guys, I'm not going to lie. Some
big guys. This honestly is boiled down to just want and just hard work.
So you're saying,
like we say with the academy, # everything earned, right? Nothing given, everything earned.
Facts. So you're saying if you want it, you can achieve it, right?
Exactly.
You know where I heard that last saying from? The saying I just said, if you want, you can achieve it.
Where's that?
From Form Academy. Listen
Shout
up.
Shout out Form Basketball
Academy. I'm telling you. They put
you guys are crazy. No doubt, no doubt.
French, but Form Academy tells you and tells you how to do it. And with Coach Paul by your side, anything's achievable. All right.
No doubt. I appreciate it. I appreciate it.
All love. Let's see. Let's talk about the NBA. Why not, right? All right. I'm a Raptors fan. I'm still sticking with our last title. That was, you know, something that I didn't think I would be able to see for a little while, but it came sooner than expected. But with Kawhi being gone, do you think we actually have another chance at a potential title? Like, I am a true Raptors fan. I have my room is covered in all the Raptors jerseys. And it's just been my family for some time, you know what I mean? I remember my first jersey when I was 4 years old. But I want to hear your guys' ideas, your opinions. I know you guys are not Raptors fans, including Coach Oli, who I don't even want to talk to you about this topic because...
Wait. Hold on.
I can't even say it.
Let me say it myself.
Okay, but I'll ask the question first. Do you think the Raptors have a potential championship future?
Future?
These guys cannot hold it. Like, these guys without Kawhi cannot hold it.
No, future for sure. Yes, they have a chance. But currently, right now, like in the season, I'm saying they finish the season off as like a low around five to eight seed team.
Do you think they'll make the championship, like, or make the finals or the playoffs?
I don't think they are.
You think this year is going to make the playoffs?
They'll make the playoffs. I know that. Fred VanVleet, I don't know, crazy
player. My guy hit 54 franchise record beat. Who would have thought? I was doing a little bit of research earlier today on Fred VanVleet. Let's see. Let me just pull this up.
He came from the G League, right?
He's a 6'1" guard. He's 26 years old, right? He drafted in 2016.
Undrafted.
You think, like,
he's undrafted, actually.
Undrafted. Yeah, my bad. He's smaller than me, and I, like, this guy, this is a true definition of if you want it, you're going to get it. You know what I mean? I weigh more than him, taller than him, but this guy worked his – can I say the word, Coach?
Family-friendly show.
Worked his
– butt off.
Budget. He worked his butt off. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just saying, family-friendly, you know? But he worked his butt off, and he guys like we idol, Vince Carter, Tracy McGrady, DeMar DeRozan, even Kawhi Leonard, the most recent superstar we had here. This guy put off a franchise record, and was it a dub? I'm not gonna lie, I did not watch the game, but was that a dub that game?
Yeah, they beat Orlando.
There we go. Who's on Orlando that we know of?
Vukovic, Evan Fournier.
Yep.
But the former person that had the record with the Raptors, 51, our boy T. Ross.
Terrence Ross, yeah.
T. Ross had that record. Another
dropped guy. 51. He dropped 51 as the Raptor.
Another. He's not. You wouldn't think of him to be as like a superstar. Am I wrong? Like,
he was a shooter. Star.
I knew T. Ross as a dunker. As a dunker. Same. That's what we saw him in 2K. He was just
2K14. Old school.
Yeah. Old school. We're talking about like 2015, 2016. Yeah. He was known as like a dunker, not a shooter.
Yeah, well, you never watched him when he played at Washington. When he was in college, he was a pure shooter.
How many years ago was that?
Oh, it's probably like
eight,
9 years ago, I'm thinking.
I think so. Anyways, I think some of the listeners want to know who my favorite team is.
Oh my god, I don't want to hear it, but okay. We'll listen to this. I'm a mute. I cannot hear this actually. I have to. All right,
I'm gonna just say it. My favorite team is the Golden State Warriors. No.
I'm gonna mute.
Bro, they just beat the Mavs blowout by 31 points.
Let me ask you a question, Coach Oli. How long have you been a Golden State Warriors?
So, all right.
Was it the Curry era where millions of other people became fans, or was it a true, like, Golden State.
Like, I didn't start watching the NBA until like 2012, I think. So that's when like Miami won it, the championship.
LeBron was on the Miami, yeah.
Yeah. So I started liking Curry and like watching Curry and Klay, the Splash Brothers, in 2013. Their record wasn't even that good. You're and I just liked the way.
In 2013, you were how old? What? 12?
Grade 7, grade 6, 12? I think.
At 12 years old, you were watching the Golden State Warriors and noticing how Curry and Klay's record was at 12 years old.
No, the record, the team record, Golden State Warrior team record.
So you're telling me at 12 years old, you were looking at all this?
They were, no, I was just looking, I was just amazed at how well they were able to shoot the ball, catch and shoot, off the dribble, all the.
Yeah, but you must have been one of the only ones. Like, not a lot of people around the world were even there was no hype around these two, the Splash Brothers, as we know them.
They were just called the Splash Brothers, and that's where they got the hype from, and that's how I found out about them. And most people are gonna call me bandwagoners, but like,
I am one of those people.
Okay, acceptable, but
very acceptable.
I have proof that I was a fan since 2013. So
well, maybe in the next episode, I would need to see this approved. How about that? Does it sound good, Coach?
All right, for sure. I'll show you.
Hey, Coach Paul, I have a question for you. Who's your team? Who's your ride or die team? Not no bandwagoner stuff. And
well, being from Ontario, being a Toronto guy, being a London guy, my team's the Raptors.
There we go.
Straight out. You know, I was 95 when they first came in the league. I won't tell you how old I was, but I remember that day. I remember watching that game. They played, here it is, real talk. They played out of the Sky Dome. They didn't even play at the ACC, or I think it's called Scotiabank Arena now. They played their first games at the Sky Dome, which, shout out to my Toronto Blue Jays, that's where the Jays play, right? So they've come a long way. They've done a lot of things in the 25 plus years they've been in the league. But my question to you, Producer P is what I'm known as for this segment. I want to know who you guys think, and you guys can answer this one each. I want to know who you guys think is going to win the NBA championship. Are the Lakers going to run it back, or someone else is going to dethrone them? Coach Oli, let me hear you.
All right. So what I'm thinking is, it's got to be a team from the West Side. The West Side is way too dominant. East Side, it's just because the East Side is too even. No team is really dominant. I think you told me the other day, Producer P, no team in the East has won like 3 games in a row or something this season so far.
Up until that time, I think it was like last week they were saying that.
So, exactly. So what I'm thinking is one of the three, all right? So LA, Lakers, or the Clippers, or Utah.
The Clippers. Whoa.
Utah.
Okay, sorry. Let him finish.
Okay, let's hear this.
But the Clippers.
So who's the third one?
Utah.
Oh, yeah, give me the Jazz. They're nice.
But
so Clippers are at the bottom of the list right now. So Lakers and Jazz are the ones that I'm thinking about primarily.
I'm going to have to deny the
Clippers.
The Clippers.
I'm iffy about that. I'm not entirely sure, but like the record.
That was your second choice. Right, you can't be iffy about your second choice.
No, that's not.
Hey, that's his decision. Coach Anand, let me hear you. What you got to say?
All right.
Yeah, let's hear it.
My point of view now. Okay.
All right.
As we know, I'm not going in order, just letting you know. I'm just saying stuff that's coming too straight to the mind. As we all know, James Harden has joined the Brooklyn Nets.
Oh, no, this man ain't going to talk about the Nets.
I'm just saying, even though the chemistry may not be 100% right now, they are a pretty big contender against, I would say, the Lakers.
This man's talking to Holly. Coach Oli, you listen to this man?
No, I'm just saying. Don't get me wrong. All right.
Let's hear your other two options.
Don't get me wrong. I was kind of shocked when the Nets lost to Cleveland, not once but twice. But I feel like if Kevin Durant, Kyrie Irving, and James Harden get their shit together and work together as a unit, that's a pretty scary force right there.
That is.
Just like people had doubts about LeBron James and Anthony Davis. You know how LeBron James passes the ball to AD, even if it's a game on the line type of shot? That trust? I feel like if these three brothers have that trust, oh, it's going to be scary. Which team right now has three actual superstars in the eyes of the people? Like LeBron just got AD. Don't get me wrong. Like, AD is a GOAT and LeBron's the GOAT. But that's only two. What other teams? Curry? Like, the Warriors?
The Warriors got Curry. They got Klay coming back.
Klay's not a superstar.
Klay is not a superstar. Klay is not you're talking about, like, super, like... Yeah, okay.
I'm talking about, like, goated. Like, right. Klay would never be... If Klay went to a different team, he would not have any championships.
Right.
I don't care what team you put him on.
Ooh, this man's
right.
Craziness right now. All right.
Let me think.
If LeBron was on Golden State and replaced Curry or Klay, then he would win it too. They were a stacked team when they won. Now they're slipping with all these injuries.
All right.
I'm just speaking stuff that bandwagoners don't want to hear. Don't hate me. I'm saying Kevin Durant, he's a 6'11", listed 6'11". I believe he's taller than 6'11", right? Maybe not fucking 7'5", but he is up there. I think hitting 7 for sure. He's a shooter. He's a slasher. He plays defense. What
that's
else?
That's a bit of a stretch.
He doesn't play defense, coach?
He's lengthy. He can block. He can block shots.
I'm not saying he's like a hardcore defensive player like Pat Beverly, but he also his height is a severe advantage to his game. He's also older. He's losing his edge a little bit. I'll grant you guys that. And there's Kyrie Irving. Yes, he's one of the most gifted ball handlers in the league. But his head's not in the right mind space. Then there's James Harden, who is breaking multiple COVID restriction rules, and he's gained a lot of weight. But if they all get their stuff together, I feel like this team could be a potential team to remember for sure.
All right.
Like they all have their issues, but to get their stuff together right now. I'm scared for the NBA. This is going to be like Golden State in their prime. And I hate to say it, but this could be a good one.
All right, so we just got to summarize here. Your teams are the Nets. Real quick, who are your other two teams do you think that might win the ship?
Lakers?
Okay, Lakers. Who's your third?
Okay. My third? I don't have a third, coach. I'm not going to lie. I haven't been watching the NBA. I'm paying that much of close attention. I've been busy with work and school, but those are my two well-known teams that I can actually speak facts on. I don't want to speak on any other team because I don't have the information on it.
All right. Real quick, we're going to shift because we talked about the NCAA before. We're going to wrap up the show soon, but we got to ask. Coach Anand, we're going to ask you real quick.
What's up?
Gonzaga or Baylor, the two undefeateds right now, well, marquee undefeateds right now, as I think there's another team that's, I think, Drake is at number 25 in the country, and they're undefeated. But the two number one and two, Gonzaga number one, Baylor number two. Who do you think is going to win the NCAA national championship? So March Madness is coming up in March. About
Gonzaga Bears? Or, I mean, Bulldogs?
Gonzaga Bulldogs. The Bulldogs.
Yeah, the Bulldogs. Yeah. Coach, you
Baylor
know,
Bears.
You know my background and what Tri-State went to, right? I'm just speaking off the top of my head. These Gonzaga has the same logo as Churchill. So regardless of anything, I have to speak for Gonzaga. But last time these two played off, right, March 23rd, 2019, I believe, Gonzaga took the dub 83-71, right? And they had a 32-3 record, and Baylor Bears had a 20-14 record. So I'm saying their coaching and their staff has been really good with their what's it called, their training
and the development. Shout out to Coach Mark Few and Gonzaga. Yep.
I'm gonna have to stick with Gonzaga Bulldog. I think they have this in the bag. I'm actually worried. Even though Baylor Bears has been making a comeback this year, I just think with the experience Gonzaga Bulldogs have, with the type of atmosphere and type of pressure on the line, the Bulldogs have this.
Coach Oli, let's hear from you.
Specifically saying the Gonzaga-Baylor matchup, I think Gonzaga's going to win just because of their freshman recruit with Jalen Suggs. Super athletic. He can shoot. He can pass. He can dunk the ball extremely well. And then their senior center, I forgot his name, but he is one of the – also Timmy. He's one of the league or NCAA's best players right now, currently, I think. But there is a team that I'm kind of rooting for right now that hasn't been playing well in the last 3-4 years-ish, which is the UCLA Bruins.
Not just at UCLA.
I did say that.
Explain yourself.
I think the coach doesn't believe in the one-and-done rule. And he's basically limiting the minutes to his freshman players who accept the limited minutes and are willing to train under this coach and this program. And it's doing extremely well so far. They lost like a really tough, heartbreaking game to Stanford the other day by like a buzzer beater layup or something.
And let me just talk about that. Defense. That was bad defense.
That was terrible defense.
That was the whole defense. I saw that on IG.
You can't let the ball come in towards the basket with 0.7 seconds left on the clock. You got to push that out to the perimeter.
That was terrible. Mistakes are made.
That's just bad defense.
Lost a game. That can't happen. Bad defense. At that level, like, coach, you coach at this level, right?
Sure.
Is this the type of mistakes that are made?
Listen, guys, mistakes happen, but I actually talked to my head coach. Shout out to Coach Chang, University of Windsor Men's Lancers program. That's where I coach at. I asked Coach Chang the question. He said, hold the inbounds 5 seconds, right? And if you're going to do anything, push it out to the perimeter. You can't have allow a back door to the rim, because that's the only way you're going to win in that situation.
Yeah, I don't know what that guy was thinking, but like as a young basketball player, that's what you're taught, to like protect the basket when you're defending the inbound pass.
That's basic basketball. You learn this in grade 8-9 basketball in high school. We're talking about NCAA, right, coach?
That's correct, sir.
So this is the type of stuff you've been picked, you've been trained, you've been coached by the top of the top, the best of the best. And to make a simple mistake like that, that's just, especially with all that on the line, that's just unacceptable. Even though it sounds as harsh as it may sound, that's the reality, right? So I hope those guys doing those suicide lines and make sure they don't make that mistake again.
Mistakes happen. So real quick before we wrap up here, some stuff that are happening. Producer P letting y'all know it. Our training academy, we are still accepting registrations. So if you're a youth, you know, you're a youngster from the age of from grade 7 all the way to grade 12, we are saying, join us. We will train you. We will gladly have you to our program. We focus on a lot of fundamentals. We focus on some, you know, basketball in-game scenarios. We also focus on academics. You know, in our next segment, we'll touch on some scholarship stuff, not too much, not too deep. Just, you know, if you're looking for a scholarship, we'll tell you how to send a proper email to a coach. Just don't send them your highlight pack. We'll tell you the up and coming programs around the country in Canada, right? We'll also touch on, hopefully the restrictions get lifted soon. We'll talk about some form events that are coming up, including our team tryouts. And you won't hear too much from me. You'll hear a lot more from Coach Oli and Coach Anand that has wanted to be part of it for the first show. So thank you for having this old man say his spiel, give his voice. I know that you guys are going to rock this show. Hope we get lots of people tuning in from around the country, coast to coast, here in Canada and in the U.S. Once again, this has been a minute, hosted by
Coach Anand
and Coach Oli.
Yes, and sir. Coach Anand, Coach Cam, who's going to be the third person to this trio. He's currently away at school. He'll be back in April, and he'll be joining in here and there, but he'll be joining in full time in April. Once again, guys, this has been a minute. We will be posting every Sunday, I believe, guys, every Sunday.
Every Sunday it is.
Every Sunday. Tune in on SoundCloud. Check out our socials. Hit us up at Form Basketball. That's f.o.r.m._basketball on Instagram. Find us on Twitter at Form Basketball. But if you just check us out on Instagram, we are going to post something cool tomorrow, that being February the 5th, 2021. Once again, thanks for tuning in. We hope that you enjoyed this first segment. In our next show, we're definitely going to talk about the Olympics and Team Canada. We're going to talk about Olympic qualifiers. We're going to talk about some cool basketball training and skills development stuff that you guys can do from home by yourself, or what we teach through the academy, and a whole bunch of other stuff that we got coming for you guys. We also have some guest speakers on, so you want to tune in. You're going to get some USports coaches. You're going to get some NCAA coaches. And we might just get some NBA coaches as well, too. Wink, wink.
Say word.
True that.
Okay.
You know how we do at Form Basketball. We come correct.
Coach, yes, Paul, sir. Come on the plug, all right?
We're coming at you live here in Vancouver. We're coming correct. So make sure you tune in. Again, SoundCloud. Hit us up on our socials. And I think Coach Ollie's got a little something for us before we bounce.
Guys, that's it for us this week. Tune in next week when we'll hit the topics. And until then, we're out. Peace.
Stay balling, boys.
Oh. Yes, sir. Yeah. Sometimes we laugh, sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Woo. Baby. I took a half and she took the whole thing. Slow down.